Journal's Decision Makers.
Welcome back to State Journal's Decision Makers. And remember, if you want to see this show or many of our old shows, all you have to do is go to statejournal.com or the website of your favorite West Virginia media station and click on the Decision Makers tab. Well, there's a national conversation going on about gun rights, and joining us today, Keith Morgan with the West Virginia Citizens Defense League. Keith, you live here in Charleston, and thanks so much for being with us.
Glad to be here.
Well, Keith, America is really just in the beginning stages of a long overdue debate and conversation about the place of guns in our society. You're with the West Virginia Citizens Defense League. Tell me what it is you all stand for. What are you all trying to get done?
Well, we support firearms ownership and carrying of firearms for self-defense, lawful recreational shooting and hunting. I have to take issue with the immediate premise that we've started out with, that it's a long overdue discussion. The discussion is as old as the country itself. The framers set everything up and settled that discussion pretty well with the wording and language of the Second Amendment, and just recently in the Heller and McDonald cases, the Supreme Court held that it is an individual right to keep and bear arms.
It is not settled, and this country has not had a rational debate because people start like, oh, well, we got to have guns.
I'm glad you used the term rational. So,
let's talk. You can't tell me that AK-47s and some of these high action military with big clips, that's not what our founders had in mind.
Well, wait a minute.
Why would we?
I'm gonna stop you right there.
All right.
Okay. I want you to go and read Federalist Papers number 46, where Madison, a Federalist, a proponent of a powerful central government, lays out the purpose for the Second Amendment. And his intent was that the citizenry be equally armed as a standing army.
So should we be able to have nuclear bombs?
Well, and you know, if you're going to talk about nuclear weapons and ridiculous arguments like that, we can terminate the interview because that's that.
But
I thought you said rational. You said rational, right?
Right. But you just said
nuclear weapons and possessions.
But your comment was that the intent of the papers was that everybody be equal to the government. But the truth of the matter is
the modern infantry soldier.
But that's not possible today. It's not possible that we can compete with this giant military machine.
I'm not advocating that we should try.
Okay, but
let me talk about your argument. You're saying AK-47s and assault rifles. First off, you're using a media coined misnomer called an assault rifle. An assault rifle is a fully automatic weapon, and those are extraordinarily difficult to keep in private hands.
But nevertheless, have been used in some of these recent killings.
Oh, sure, they have, and those are tragic. But I'm going to ask you a question.
Would you support getting rid of those to the public?
Absolutely not. And let me ask you a question. Do you support removing those from law enforcement? Now, the Kanawha County Sheriff's Department, West Virginia State Police are running around out here with AR-15s and 30-round magazines. Do you think they should have
them? I do think they should have
them. You do? Okay, well, they face the same threats we do. Why do you think they should have them and we should not?
Because I believe that our police and our military are trained to defend us and to protect this country. I don't think that I want every guy up and down the block going out thinking that he is, you know, Rambo, and he's going out to save the country.
Okay.
I mean, I just don't think the irrational part of this conversation.
You are making an unfair and frankly offensive accusation that people who own rifles with 30-round magazines think they're Rambo. Because I can take you just up the street here and we can go talk to some MDs. They're pretty sure that they are not Rambo. They're citizens, they're professionals, they're doctors and lawyers, and yes, even people in the media who own these firearms.
But what's the purpose?
What's the purpose? The purpose is self-defense. That's the same purpose for law enforcement.
Who is it you're defending yourself from?
who is it the law enforcement defends themselves from? No, there is a criminal element in our society.
But
you disagree?
Law enforcement has a responsibility to track down, capture, and in some cases defend. The citizens don't have that.
There is a misconception in society. Law enforcement, and the Supreme Court has held multiple times, that law enforcement has no duty to defend you.
Well, I think you're up on a technicality. Law enforcement does, in fact,
they have no duty to defend you.
But the reality is
they have no duty to protect you.
The reality is they do.
The reality is they do not. I'm sorry. Well, I don't know where you're getting your information.
Well, I'm getting it from real life experience.
Mine comes from the Supreme Court of the United States, thus the law of the land.
You might notice on the police cars it says to protect, you know, to defend and protect.
Let me tell you, what it says on the side of the police car is at odds with what the Supreme Court of the United States. They have no duty to protect you. And anybody out there who believes they do, you better think again.
So, I want to get back to this. I don't understand what the need is for anybody, for a citizen, to have an AK-47, a grenade launcher, all of that kind of stuff. Why do you need
why
that?
Why are you talking about grenade launchers?
Because that's a weapon. That's a gun.
Wait a minute.
The projectile it shoots is a grenade. It's a big bullet.
But I want to understand why you're talking about grenade launchers. Did we have some attacks by grenade launchers in the United States while I wasn't looking?
I'm talking about that when this Constitution.
You're bringing up red herrings for the interest and for the purpose of eliciting an emotional response, and it's a little weak in my opinion.
Well,
I thought we were going to have a rational discussion.
Well,
rational discussion is about we're dealing with the same threats. We face the same burglars, the same criminals, the same murderers that law enforcement do. And you would have us hamstrung by limited capacity magazines. And the reality is, you really want to cause a problem in this state, or in this country, you go ahead and you outlaw assault weapons, because the United States can't keep people, human beings, from crossing our southern border. Now, when you go and you create a market for machine guns, you can bet they're going to flow. We're going to have problems we don't now, because there will be fully automatic weapons in the streets.
All right, Keith, if you could hang on for just a second, we need to take a quick break, and we'll come right back with more on Decision Makers.
Journal's Decision Makers.
Welcome back. State Journal's Decision Makers, continuing our conversation with Keith Morgan with the West Virginia Citizens Defense League, and an interesting conversation about the place of guns in our society. And Keith, my position is, just so I can make it clear, is it is clear to me that what has happened over the last 250 years in this country is there's been an evolution of weapons. And, you know, it was an interesting divide that you made, that a grenade launcher is not, for example, the same as an AK-47. And I was using that as an example because I believe that the original purpose was sort of this idea that America could defend itself. But today, we have such a different kind of weaponry. We have such a different kind of military. And it's much different than what our founders had. And I think you can see places like Syria where you don't have to be, you know, you can find guns and you can have a revolution against the government, even if it overpowers you, and still win. What I'm worried about is what the conversation we're having is, I don't want my neighbor to have an AK-47, because the problem is, as we've seen, is people go nuts.
Well, wait a minute. All right, let's talk about what I think may be, now I don't know you. We've not met prior to today.
Yep.
You take issue, you think that your neighbor is going to go nuts with his AK-47.
I'm pretty sure.
Psychologists would call this issue projection, wherein you fear that if I placed an AK-47 in your hands right now, I handed you, I'm armed, I could lay a 9mm on the table right here. If I did that, would you pick it up and shoot me?
That's actually scary to me.
Would you pick it up and shoot me?
That's scary to me. Well, you're armed right now?
Well, sure. You're not? If I laid that handgun on the table here and took two steps to the left, would you shoot me with it?
No, I probably wouldn't.
Then why would you project that onto another person?
Well, I just...
Is it that you feel that you're better than other people and therefore you won't go crazy, but they will?
You were asking about an AK-47.
You were asking about an AK-47.
Well, you started out, your comment was an AK-47.
If I laid an AK on the table, would you pick it up and shoot me with it?
I can't imagine why anybody in this country, any citizen in this country, needs an AK-47.
You're shifting. First off, the word need
is not. I'm not going to shoot anybody with guns, so let's just be clear about
that. Okay, good.
I don't think people should have them. I don't think you should have one right now.
You're not going to shoot anybody, okay? But what then, why do you think I will?
I don't know, but why?
Why do you think that I'm going to shoot somebody I'm armed?
It's not so much at you, but I know there are a lot. Let me finish. I think there's a lot of people in this country that are unstable, and I don't think they need to be carrying guns. I don't see, in a society like this, why in the world, in everyday life, should anybody have a gun?
Well, anybody have a gun?
Anybody.
Have you been over there by Fife Street?
No.
Okay, then we are not speaking from
But if nobody had guns, I suspect there wouldn't be a problem.
If nobody had guns, this is a pipe dream. You say that, and the thought is you think that because of a ban, magically, poof, guns are going to disappear. Well, let me tell you, it worked really well with methamphetamine.
And let me be clear. I'm not for a gun ban, but I am for an assault gun ban because I don't think they have a place in our society. And I think we have
How many
people have to die?
They are great self-defense weapons.
Unfortunately, but they've never been used in self-defense. They've only been used to kill people.
That is a blatant lie. That is an absolute blatant lie, period. I can pull up hundreds, perhaps thousands in the past couple of years alone, instances of these assault weapons, which again is a misnomer.
Keith Morgan, we're running out of time.
Being used for self-defense in a legal manner.
Thank you so much, Keith Morgan. And standing by is Rob Alsop. We'll be back after this.